But Tim, I have to say that there was a moment of levity in New South Wales Parliament this week, courtesy of Mark Latham. Take a look at this.
I thank all the contributors. I noticed, though, when I moved the motion, the Honourable Anthony D'Adam was jumping up to take a point of order. He jumped up that quickly, I thought his pager had gone off.
Ooh, bit of a zinger, Tim.
A bit behind the time is, Mark, because I understand it's now not Hezbollah, it's Hezlar, because they've lost their bowls.
Very good. Very good. Now Mark, and I can see you losing it there. But Gen Z, in Into Which I Fall, it's apparently between 1995 and 2009, there's been a survey done into who's happy at work and who's not happy at work. I'm just telling the Sky bosses I'm quite happy at work right now. But Gen Z are apparently the most unhappy people in the workplace, and meanwhile the baby boomers are the happiest.
Yeah, and interesting as well, Caleb, like 71% of government workers are really happy at work as well. But what is still surprising to me is that, 100% of these people filled out a survey. I don't know about these people. Like, what are they doing at work if they're filling out surveys at work? I'd be fuming.
Well, you know what? It could be a good way to avoid doing some work, and it might make them a bit happier, Tim. But I don't know whether you saw recently, there was a campaign, or at least a social media thing, from the health department in Queensland, where they were telling people that it was okay to poo at work. I mean, is that why they're all so unhappy? They didn't realise it was okay. I always thought that if you did it on company time, you were getting paid to go to the cars.
I assume they meant do it in a, you know, in an appropriate venue, not just
at your desk.
that'd be a bit dramatic. I always think when we get these sort of surveys about workplace happiness and so on, there was a lovely line in Viz several decades ago, Viz, the British satirical magazine, advising potential employers to discard half of job application letters as soon as they arrive because you don't want to hire unlucky people. So maybe that would sort things out.
Fair enough. Now, Kamala Harris, look, if there's someone who probably is experiencing some workplace happiness right now, it's Kamala Harris. She got rid of Joe Biden. She may well be the next president of the United States. Even if she is doing a bad job, she doesn't realise she's doing a bad job, so she's quite happy anyway. But we've become used to these sort of nonsense one-liners from her, Mark, and, here's one of the latest.
I grew up understanding the children of the community are the children of the community.
Oh, the children of the community. Who would have known? I think we've heard this one before, though.
You know, when we talk about our children, I know for this group, we all believe that when we talk about the children of the community, they are a children of the community.
And what on earth is she on about, Mark?
I'm so excited, Callum. Drunk Mumala is back. We are back in. They've gotten overconfident after the debate. They've let off the strings just a little bit. They've let her flourish, go do her thing. They've gotten a bit overcocky, overconfident now. I got a few love letters last week by saying that Trump lost the debate from listeners of, watchers of the show. Weren't very kind. I was just speaking the truth. But I think this is exactly what we need to be doing with her, is just let her talk because she'll drown herself. I'm excited. I want her to keep going, Mumala. I want to see more of this.
100%. Just very quickly before we go, Tim, have a listen to Trump at a rally today.
We can do all of this and more, but patriotic New Yorkers must get your asses out to vote. Harry, get your fat ass out of the couch. You're going to vote for Trump today, Harry. Get up, Harry. Come on, let's go. Let's go, Harry.
How bloody good's that, good. Tim?
Absolutely. And now we see it. New Yorkers in play. If Harry can get up, if we can now see the phrase fat ass in a presidential campaign, anything can happen, my friend. Anything can happen. The entire Eastern Seaboard's in play.
Mate, the future of the world is on Harry's shoulders right now. Tim Blair, Mark Nicholson.
Well, I wouldn't say his shoulders, but somewhere
it might be something else. Tim Blair, Mark Nicholson, thank you for your time.